हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग CAPM, कैपिटल एसेट प्राइसिंग मॉडल। द CAPM इज द मैकेनिज्म वेयर बाय इन्वेस्टर्स आर एबल टू असेस द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ प्रपोज सिक्योरिटी इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑन देयर ओवरऑल पोर्टफोलियो रिस्क एंड रिटर्न। दिस मीन्स द इन्वेस्टर्स कैन नो वॉट इज द इफेक्ट ऑन द ओवरऑल रिस्क on account of their purchase of a new security. The CAPM shows the risk return trade-off for securities. Whether the overall risk increases with the increase with the new investment or whether the overall risk decreases with the new investment in security. The CAPM outlines the relationship between the required rate of return, which is also known as cost of equity capital, and the non-diversifiable risk, which is also known as the systematic risk. The systematic risk or non-diversifiable risk is the risk which every business enterprise has to bear. No business enterprise can escape from this risk. The risk arising out of inflation, the risk arising out of a war, the risk arising out of political instability are examples of non-diversifiable risk or systematic risk. The systematic risk is denoted by the term beta. The following equation is used. The following equation shows the relationship between the return and beta. What is the relationship between the return and the risk? This equation establishes the relationship. RS is equal to RF plus BS bracket RM minus RF. RS is what? RS is the return required on investment or cost of equity capital. RF is the risk-free return, the return that can be earned on a risk-free investment without bearing any risk. Example, US Treasury bills or Indian government bonds. These Indian government bonds or the US Treasury bills guarantee a minimum return. Therefore, they are known as risk-free investment. RM is what? RM is the average return on all securities. The return provided by Nifty, that is the NSE 50 index, S&P 500 stock index. This is RM. And BS is equal to the securities beta, systematic or non-diversifiable risk is denoted by the term BS. B is capital and S is small. Now, I will explain the concept of CAPM with the help of an example. And I hope that this example will make things very clear to the students. A security has a beta of 1.2. Risk-free rate is 4% and market return is 12%. Then RS is equal to, we have to calculate the required rate of return or the cost of equity capital. RS is equal to, as per the formula of CAPM, RF plus BS bracket RM minus RF. RF is given in the question 4% plus BS. BS is 1.2. BS is what? Beta of the security, and bracket 12 minus 4. What is 12? Return on market. The return provided by the index is 12 minus RF is what? Risk-free return minus 4, and is equal to 4 plus 1.2 bracket. Bracket means we have to multiply 12 minus 4 is 8. Is equal to 4 plus 9.6 is equal to 13.6%. So the required rate of return is 13.6%. This means that the investor requires a return of 13.6% on this investment for assuming the non-diversifiable risk beta of 1.2. I hope this example would have made things simpler for the students. Now, I am going to take another example where I decrease the beta to 1. Now, suppose the beta declines to 1. then we will calculate what is the RS. Then RS is equal to 4 plus 1 into 12 minus 4. 4 is the risk-free return, 1 is the BS, that is beta, 12 is the market return, and 4 is the risk-free return. That is 4 plus 1 bracket 8, 4 plus 8 is 12%. So we see the required rate of return declines with the decline in non-diversifiable risk. That is, if the non-diversifiable risk, that is beta, so if the beta declines to 1 from 1.2, the required rate of return also declines. It comes down to 12%. So we are seeing that the required rate of return and the beta move in the same direction. Now, suppose if the beta was higher, say 1.25, what would be the required rate of return? Again, we calculate 4% is the risk-free return plus 1.25 is the beta. 12% is the market return minus 4% risk-free return. And on solving this, we get 4% plus 1.25 multiplied by 8. That is 4% plus 10 is equal to 14%. Thus, we see that with the increase in beta, the required rate of return also increased to 14%. Therefore, we see that as per CAPM, the risk and return move in the same direction. The higher the risk, the higher the required rate of return. The lower the risk, the lower the required rate of return. That's it for today, and please continue watching the channel for more videos. Thank you.